Hey everyone, in today's lecture, we'll be discussing about a three-phase bridge inverter. In three-phase bridge inverter, there are two different conduction modes, 180 degree conduction mode and 120 degree conduction mode. In this lecture, we'll only be discussing about the 180 degree mode of conduction. Wherever necessary, please take the screenshots of the commutation patterns that I'll be showing and the tabulations that I've sketched, and please follow this lecture very carefully. Let us look into the circuit of a three-phase bridge inverter. The circuit diagram given here is for a three-phase bridge inverter. Now, this three-phase bridge inverter, it is mainly preferred for industrial applications. As it is three-phase, it can give more output power to the AC loads. Therefore, three-phase is more preferred when compared to single-phase. Comparing single-phase and three-phase is more preferred for industrial applications. Now here we can see that there are 6 thyristors. As there are 6 thyristors, it means that for 0 degree to 360 degree conduction, 360 divided by 6, I get 60 degree. Every interval will be of 60 degree duration. Now we can look here that, we can see here that in the circuit, in the input side, a capacitor is connected. Now this capacitor, it is connected in the input terminal to make the DC voltage constants, to remove whatever harmonics are present, to remove that a DC filter type of DC is connected at the input. Now speaking about how this will operate, there are two patterns that we can use for the operation of a three-phase bridge inverter. Now, in the first pattern, there will be 180 degree mode conduction. In the second pattern is 120 degree mode conduction. In 180 mode conduction, every thyristor will conduct for 180. That is, if I am turning on thyristor T1 at 0 degree, it will turn off at omega T is equal to 180 degree. 120 degree mode conduction, if I am turning on thyristor T1 at omega T is equal to 0 degree, it will turn off at omega T is equal to 120 degree. That is the gating patterns that we are using. Gating patterns means the gating pulse that I am giving. Now in both these modes, the 60 degree interval is followed. 60 degree interval means what? After every 60 degree, after every omega T is equal to 60 degree, a new thyristor will turn on. Now let us look into the first mode of operation, that is three-phase 180 degree mode VSI. VSI is nothing but a voltage source inverter. In earlier inverter classes, we have seen that the bridge inverter that we have discussed, it was a VSI. So this is here also we are discussing about a three-phase bridge inverter. Therefore, I can call it also as a VSI. VSI is nothing but voltage source inductor. Now, as we are going to discuss about 180 degree mode, what does that mean? It means that every thyristor T1 to T6, every thyristor after it is turned on, it will conduct for 180 degree. Now, one thing that we have to understand here is that to phase A, two thyristors are connected, T1 and T4. To phase B, two thyristors are connected, T3 and T6. To phase C, two thyristors are connected, T5 and T2. Now we can see here that T1, T5, T3, it forms the positive group or the upper group. Positive group is nothing but always here the load current, the direction of load current will be positive. For example, let us take the direction of load current to be this for the upper group. The lower group, T2, T4, T6, it consists of the lower group or the negative group. Always, if this thyristor is on, the direction of current will be opposite. That is, the load current, for example, if it is positive in the upper group, it will be negative for the lower group. This thing we have to keep in mind.
Now we already know that each thyristor it will conduct for 180 degree. That and one more thing we have to ensure here is that if, for example, if I am having upper group, that is T1, T3, T5. If T1 is turned on at 0 degree, after 120 degree, T3 will turn off. Turn on. After 120 degree of turning on of T3, at 240 degree, T5 will turn on. T1 will conduct for 180 degree. But when T1 is on, at the last 60 degree of T1, T2 will also turn on. T3 will also turn on. That is the upper group. Similar case for the lower group as well. If lower group T4, T6, T2, if T4 is turned on at 0, T6 will get turned on at 120, T2 will get turned on at 240. This thing we have to keep in mind. Now let us look into the gating pattern. Now here we can see that the upper group, I'm denoting it as plus, and the lower group I'm denoting it as minus. The upper group thyristors are T1, T3, T5. The lower group thyristors are T4, T6, T2. T1 and T4 conducts for A, T3, T6 for B, T5, T2 for C phase. Now what will happen is, at 0 degree, thyristor T1 will turn on. Now after thyristor T1 is turned on, it will conduct for 120 degree. After reaching 120 degree, we can see that thyristor T3 will turn on. After T3 is turned on, after T3 is 120 degree, T5 will turn on. Similarly, after T5 is turned on, T1. After 120 degree of T5, T1 will turn on. Now this thing, it is clearly evident. Now moving further, after T4 is turned on, T4, the hashed is the negative group. After T4 is turned on, after it's 120 degree, T6 will turn on. After T6, 120 degree, T2 will turn on. Now we can see the pattern. T1, T3, T5. T1, T3, T5. Then we can see T4, T6, T2. Okay. Now, one more thing I have said about the 60 degree interval. Now we can see here that after at 0 degree, T1 is turned on. Then at 60 degree, we can see T2 is turned on. At 60 degree, after 60 degree or 120 degree, we can see that T3 is turned on. At 180, T4 is turned on. 240, T5, 300, T6, again at 360 degree, again T1 is getting turned on. That is, after every 60 degrees, one thyristor is going to turn on. Now this is quite clear. Here we can see that from 0 to 360, there are 6 steps, or there are 6 modes of operation. Again after 360, again 0 to 360 cycle will continue. Now it is quite clear, this is the conduction pattern. Conduction pattern means for what duration every switch is on. Now from the diagram it is quite clear that T1 is on for 180 degree. T2 is also on for 180 degree, T3 is also on for 180 degree, T4 is on for 180 degree. That is, if I look at the 0 to 60 degree duration, I can see that thyristor T1, T6 and T5, all these 3 thyristors are turned on. That is, at 0 degree to 60 degree, thyristor T1, then thyristor T6 and thyristor T5 is turned on. Now here we can see that thyristor T6 will give a positive current to A phase. Thyristor T5 will also give a positive current to C phase. But thyristor T6 will give a negative current to B phase. Is this clear? As already I have said, T6 is a negative group or a lower group thyristor. Therefore, T6 will give negative current to B phase. T1 and T5 both are upper group thyristors. Therefore, T1 will give positive current to A phase and T5 will give positive current to C phase. Now, let us move further. Now, before moving further, I have sketched a table. Now, let me show you how I am getting the values in this table. Now, let us consider step 1. In step 1, we know that I am giving Vs. My thyristor T1 is on. Now, let us consider R load. My thyristor T1 is on here. And as thyristor T1 is on, it is getting connected to A phase. This is 0. This is C. This point is B. This is 0 point. R. This is thyristor T1. This is thyristor T5. This is thyristor T6 on. Not able to understand? Let me move back to the diagram here. Now here you can see that thyristor T1 is connected to A phase. Once more, please look clearly. T5 is connected to C phase. T6 is connected to B phase. And it is connected to the negative terminal. T6 is connected to the negative terminal. T1 and T5 is connected to the positive. I'll sketch it again. Very clearly we have to see in the step 1, 0 to 60 degree mode, T1, T5, T6 are conducting. I'll get something like this. This is for A phase, this is for C phase, this is for B phase. Now I am considering a resistive load. This is my Vs. Now a load current I0 is flowing. How we'll calculate I0? I'll calculate I0 is equal to total voltage divided by total resistance. Vs divided by, here we can see that R and R is in parallel. This parallel connection is connected in series with a R. Therefore, I can write it to be R plus R by 2. Therefore, I'll get I0 is equal to 2 by 3 Vs by R. This is the value of total value of the load current that is flowing. Now, I have to calculate VA0. VA0 is nothing but the voltage between phase and neutral, VCO. This is the parallel component. Two parallel R's we had. So I will get I0 into R. The parallel resistance is R by 2. In each branch it is R by 2. So I will get it to be Vs by 3. VA0 and VC0, I will get it to be Vs by 3. Now calculating for VB0, B, I have said B is in negative group T6. Therefore, I'll get it to be minus I0 into R. Why? Because it was a single component or the series component, series connected R. Therefore, R, I'll get it to be minus 2 by 3 Vs. Okay. Now, let us look at the table. I am calculating line to neutral voltage. When I am calculating line to neutral voltage, I can see that initially for VA0, I am getting it to be plus Vs by 3, and VC0 also I am getting it to be plus Vs by 3. VB0, I am getting it to be minus 2 Vs by 3. We can see that in the first, we have conduction of T1, T6 and T5. T1, T6 and T5. T6 is the negative group, T1 and T5 is the positive group. Therefore, I am getting Vs by 3, Vs by 3, and T6 I am getting it to be minus 2 Vs by 3. In the next cycle, we can see that T1, T6 and T2 are conducting. Therefore, T1, T6 and T2 are conducting, we know that T1 is the positive group, T6 and T2 is the negative group. T1 is the positive group. So T1 is for A phase, T6 is for B phase, T2 is for C phase. Therefore, I can see that in the positive group, I am getting plus 2 Vs by 3. As in the negative group earlier, we have seen that for the negative group, only one resistor was there. When only one resistor was there, I got the value to be 2 Vs by 3. Now, as it is negative current is flowing, I am getting it to be minus 2 Vs by 3. In this case, I'll get a diagram something like this. Here, because of this, I'll get Vs by 3. And here two components in the negative group are present. Therefore, I'm getting it to be minus Vs by 3, minus Vs by 3. Now, moving on to the third part. In the third step, we can see that T1, T3 and T2 is conducting. T1, T3 and T2. T1 is for A phase, T3 is for B phase, T2 is for C phase, T2 is negative, T3 is positive, T1 is positive, T1 and T3 is positive, T2 is negative group. So here we can see that for T1, I am getting plus Vs by 3, for B, I am getting plus Vs by 3, for VCO, I am getting it to be minus 2 Vs by 3. In the fourth step, we can see that T4, T3, T2 is conducting. T4, T3, T2 is conducting. T4 is for A phase, T3 is for B phase, T2 is for C phase. Here we can see that T2 and T4 both are negative. T3 is for positive current. So here it is clearly evident that A phase and C phase I am having minus Vs by 3. For B phase I am having plus 2 Vs by 3. In this manner, I can calculate all the values. Plus Vs by 3, for that is line voltage, line to neutral voltage. In the first step, it will be plus Vs by 3, then plus 2 Vs by 3, plus Vs by 3, minus Vs by 3, minus 2 Vs by 3, minus Vs by 3. So if I am plotting the graph, I will get something like this. This will be 0. Okay. In the similar manner, VBO, VCO. Now here we can see that what all thyristors are on. In the 165, 162. So as I have said, 1 and 4 is for A, 3 and 6 is for B, 5 and 2 is for C. These are the negative group. This is the positive group. Keeping all those things, I can easily form this table. All the values in this table can be easily formed. Now I have to calculate the line voltage. How I'll calculate the line voltage? VAB is equal to VAO minus VBO. I know that the value of VAO, the value of VAO is Vs plus Vs by 3. The value of VBO is minus 2 Vs by 3. So I'll get Vs by 3 minus of minus 2 Vs by 3, which is equal to Vs. I am getting plus Vs as VAB. In this manner, all the values, if I am calculating, I will get the values in this manner. Similarly for VBC, minus Vs, 0 Vs, Vs, 0, minus Vs. So for example, if I am plotting VAB, I will get Vs, Vs for 2 cycles, then a 0, then a 0, then again minus Vs. So I'm getting some square pulses in this manner. I'm getting some square pulses in this manner with a gap zero period. Now let us look into the waveform of this. Let us combine all the concepts that we have learned together. Now we can see here that the first diagram that I have sketched, and from the table I can see that I am getting plus Vs by 3. So here plus Vs by 3, then plus 2 Vs by 3 for the second step, then again Vs by 3, then I am getting minus Vs by 3, then minus 2 Vs by 3, then again Vs by 3. This is the line to neutral voltage I have sketched. Now from this, I have sketched this one. From the second table, I can sketch this one. from the third column I can sketch the third VAO, VBO, VCO. Now in the similar manner VAB can be sketched using this column, VBC using this column, and let us look what all values we are getting. VS, VS, 0, minus VS, minus VS, 0. Let us check. VS, VS, 0, minus VS for 2 cycles and 0. In this manner, I can complete the waveform. Now here in the waveform also it is quite clear that what all are the conducting thyristors, which all thyristors are turned on. After every 60 degree duration, a new thyristor is turned on. We can see that all the thyristors are conducting for 180 degree. It is quite clear. T1, T3, T5, upper half thyristors, they are turning on it after 120 degree in the same pattern. You can see here after 120 degree. After 120 degree, T3 is turning on. After T3 is turned on, after it's 120 degree, T5 is turning on. Similarly, for the lower group thyristors, it is quite evident. After T4 is turned on, after 120 degree of that, T6 is turned on. After T6 is turned on, 120 degree, after 120 degree of T6, T2 is turned on. In this manner, we can look at the waveforms. I think it is quite clear. It is a little bit confusing. You have to go through all these steps one by one. Once it is solved, this pattern can easily be made. Now I am not discussing about 120 degree mode of conduction. In 120 degree mode, what will happen is T1, after T1 is turned on, here some hashed portion will come. Here also some hashed portion will come. Here also some. That is, during this duration, T1 is off. During this duration, T3 is off. During this duration, T5 is off. Same thing. That is, in first step, I'll get 1 and 6, operation of 1 and 6, because T5 will also be on. In the second, I'll get 1 and 2, operation because of 1 and 2 in the second step. In the third step, I'll get operation because of 3 and 2. This is the only change for 120 degree. For 120 degree mode conduction as well, it can be done in this similar pattern. I hope all of you are clear with the concept of three phase bridge inverter.